Hey guys, what's up? This is Manas, your friend and tutor, and I'm back with another video on friction. Today, again, it's going to be one more problem based on wedge friction. This is going to be beautiful, so watch this video right till the end. Here we go. So there are essentially two blocks. One is this 1000 Newton block, which has to be tightened. How is this done? Well, we are doing this with the help of this wedge. We are pushing this wedge in the downward direction with this force P. And this is the force which we need to find. Now, if you watch carefully, this 1000 Newton block is in contact over here along this horizontal surface and just a little bit along this vertical surface. Now, when this wedge is driven in the downward direction, the block, 1000 Newton block, will push towards this vertical surface and it will slide slightly towards the right along this horizontal surface. So there is going to be friction only at this point, and let's call this point as point one. There will be no friction along this vertical surface. Secondly, the point of contact is this one. Okay, the wedge is in contact with this 1000 Newton block, and let's call this as point of contact two. And finally, the point of contact of this, say, wedge with the wall, you can say, let's call this as point of contact three. Now guys, what we need to do is we need to make the free body diagram of both the blocks, that is the wedge as well as the block. And here we go, it's going to be fun. Watch this. And here it is, these are the forces. Okay, so this is point one. So obviously there is going to be a normal. This is going to be N1. Now if you watch carefully, I told you, if you're trying to drive this wedge in the downward sense, this block will have a tendency to slightly move towards the right, isn't it? And in that process, it will have a friction force slightly towards the left, this way. And this is going to be mu n. Mu n is nothing but this is mu for all the contacting surfaces and times of normal, that is n1. That is mu n1. It's that simple. Secondly, this block B is in contact with this wedge. Okay, so the wedge is going to offer a normal to this block B. And that normal is represented by, let's say, N2, since this is point of contact 2. Well, if this is the action N2 onto this 1000 Newton block, there is going to be a reaction in the form of this N2, that is blue colored arrow. Magnitude is same, the direction is slightly different. Now, this blue colored arrow is from this 1000 Newton block onto this wedge. That's it. And there is obviously going to be a friction force. If you watch carefully, this wedge will try to move in the downward direction. Therefore, this block, 1000 Newton block, will offer it a friction in the upper direction. Okay, friction force from this block B, 1000 Newton block B, onto this wedge will be in the upper direction. Why? Because the wedge is trying to move in the downward direction. That's why. Similarly, if this is the action, there is going to be a reaction over here. And obviously, action and reaction, the magnitude is going to be same, mu n. And here the normal is n2, so mu n2 here as well as here. That's it. Mu's value is 0.25 at every point of contact. That's it. And finally, we have this. This is going to be N3, normal to the surface, N3 here. And this is, since this is trying to move in the downward direction, therefore friction force in the upward direction. And that's 0.25 N3. Now guys, whenever we do the force analysis, we do F of x is equal to 0, all the forces, in fact, and F of y is equal to 0. Now, this P force is along the y direction. Therefore, we are going to kick off with summation of all the forces along y direction is equal to 0. And what we need to do is, each and every force acting on this wedge has to be resolved into their respective x and y components. And then only you can implement this equation. Here we go. So if you watch carefully, these are already in x and y, no problem. The problem is with this 0.25 n2 and this n2. And if this is angle 15, if you see this line and this line, both of them are parallel. So if this is angle 15, this has also got to be 15 degrees. Okay. Now what we can do is we can resolve this N2, 0.25 N2 into its components, something like this. It would be better if I can have a blue color for this purpose. Yeah, this one. It's going to have one component over here. Let me write. If this is 0.25 N2 and here it is 15 degrees, then this is going to be 0.25 N2 cos 15. And here, will have its horizontal component. 0.25 into, this is 0.25 into cos 15, and this is going to be, if this is 15 and the angle between this normal and this frictional force is 90 degrees, so out of 90 degrees this much is 15, so the remaining stuff, well, you know very well it is going to be equal to 75 degrees. So I'll just write 75 over here, 75 degrees. This is into, making an angle of 75, write this properly, 75 with this line. So therefore its component will be here. Let me just write N2 cos 75. Okay, this is N2, this is N2 cos 75, and right here we'll have N2 sin 75. So these are essentially all the forces which are acting on the wedge. And now we can kick off. Here we go. So the first thing is this force P, downward direction, negative, P negative, 0.25 N3 upwards positive, 0.25 N2 cos 15 again upwards positive, and this N2 cos 75 upwards positive. So let me put up all the forces into this equation and then let's see what happens. Here we go. Now guys, let's try to simplify this. What we can do is we can take P over to the one side and we can have the remaining stuff. Okay, and you can clearly see that N2 can be taken as common and the stuff remaining inside will be 0.25 cos 15 plus cos 75. Let me just write this. Now just try to put this up into a calculator and the coefficient of N2 that you will get is 0.5. Okay, approximately. This is going to be, let me write this properly, the value of P will work out as 0.5 times of N2 plus 0.25 times of N3. Okay, now let me call this as our equation number one, and this is the master equation that we need to work with. And you can clearly see magnitude of P depends upon two forces, that is N2 and N3. So your objective right now is very clear. You need to find the value of N2 as well as N3. And now in the same manner, let's try to work out all the forces acting along the x direction. Here we go. Let me write this. Summation of all the forces along x is equal to 0. And it's something like this. N3, okay, N3 positive as it is towards the right hand side. Anything towards the left, take it as in the negative sense. 0.25 N2 sin 15. Now guys, watch, these two forces are done. This fellow is left, N2 sin 75 is left. So it's towards the left, therefore a negative sign, minus N2 sin 75, and all of this is going to be equal to 0. Now guys, you can simplify this. You can take N2 as common and you can write 0.25. Let me show you rather. Now, if you try to put this value, put this expression into a calculator, the final value that you will get is minus 0.9012. Okay, it's going to be like this. Let me write this properly. N3 plus a negative value, minus 0.9012, and that's N2 is equal to 0. And on simplifying this further, we can write this as N3 is equal to a positive 0.9012, that's N2, and let's call this as our equation number 2. So that was all about the forces acting on the wedge, 15 degree wedge. Now let's take a look at the 1000 Newton block and let's try to decompose all the forces acting on it into the respective x and y components. Here we go. And clearly see, this is N2, all right, angle made over here, I cannot write that, it's very small space, but the angle made over here is going to be 15 degrees. Okay, remember this, this is going to be 15 degrees. Let me write it here. So this is N2, making an angle of 15 degree with this line. So this is going to be N2 cos 15. Here we go. And similarly, you'll have one more component, that is the vertical component. Somewhere here, let me write it. N2 sine 15, that's it. Okay, again, we have this 0.25 N2. It's going to have two components. If you see this angle, this is going to be the remaining, this is 15 degrees. So this much remaining is 75 and this again is going to be 15 degrees. Let me put it over here. This is going to be 15 degrees. And if you try to resolve this into components, you'll again have two components. It's going to be something like this. That's it. This is 0.25 N2 and this is 15. So this is going to be 0.25 N2 cos 15. And we have one more component in this direction, that is 0.25 N2 sine 15. Okay, so we've more or less worked out all the forces. I think we have. Let me check it once again. This is N2. Okay, this is making an angle of 15 degrees over here. So this is N2 cos 15, this is N2 sine 15, this is 0.25 N2. Here also we'll have 15 degree angle, so this is 0.25 N2 cos 15 and this is 0.25 N2 sine 15. So all the forces have been worked out. Okay, now let's get back to work. So you don't have to resolve these two forces into components as they already lie in x and y directions. Let's kick off with this summation of all the forces along x direction is equal to 0. Okay. So we're going to kick off with this N2 cos 15 right inside, positive. And what else? This 0.25 N1 left inside, negative. And we have this 0.25 N2 sine 15. Here we go. Plus, minus, minus. So that's it. Now the next thing that we can do is, from these two terms, we can take N2 as common and then we can write the remaining stuff. And it's going to look something like this. Let me write this over here. Implies that if N2 has been taken as common, the remaining stuff is cos 15 minus 0.25 sine 15. And we have this 0.25 N1. Now, if you try to put this up into a calculator, the value of the coefficient of N2 that you will get will be 0.901. Let me write this. And let's call this as our equation number 3. Now guys, let's try to take a look at all the forces acting along the y direction. So I should write over here, summation of all the forces acting along the y direction is equal to 0. So let's have a look. 1000 Newton block. So this force is downwards. So this is going to be negative. Fine. N1 is upwards, positive. And what else? These two forces, 0.25 N2 cos 15 and this N2 sine 15 also, both of them downwards, therefore negative. Three forces are negative. This one, and this one. One force is positive. That is N1. So let's start. Now the best thing to do is to take this N2 as common and you can write the remaining stuff inside. Let me show you. And when you put this value into a calculator, the coefficient of N2 that you are going to get will be equal to 0.5 approximately. So let me write this again, minus 0.5 N2 plus N1 is equal to 1000. And let's call this as our equation number 4. So now guys, our task has become very easy. We now have two equations, that is 3 and 4 in terms of N2 and N1. So two equations and two unknowns, N2 and N1. You can easily crack it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use a calculator for this purpose. So let me get the calculator out. Here it is. Okay. Now go to mode. For equation, hit 5. This is the equation ax plus by is equal to c. Okay, so x and y are N2 and N1, and a and b for this equation will be 0.901 and negative of 0.25, and the value of c will be 0. So this is the pattern which you have to follow. So the value of a, 0.901, and hit enter. Done. Value of b, negative of 0.25, hit enter. Value of c is 0, then the value of this equation, okay, this is going to be how much? Minus 0.5, all right, minus 0.5, done. This is the coefficient, there is nothing, it's 1, hit enter, and over to the right hand side we have 1000, hit enter once again, that will give you the value of x, okay, and the value is, the value of x, that is n2, is 322.16. similarly, you can have the next value, again hit enter, that is the value of y, and the value of y in decimal is 1161.08. okay, so we really are not interested in calculating the value of y, that is n1, because we need n2. n2 can be used here to get the value of n3, and n2 and n3 both can be used over here in equation number 1 to finally get the value of point P. So let me write down all the stuff. Here we go. So on solving equation 3 and 4, now what you need to do is, you need to put the value of n2 is equal to 322 over here in equation 2, so that you can have the value of n3. n3 will precisely work out as, let me check, n3 will be 290.34, and finally put the value of n2 and n3 over to this equation 1. The value of p obtained will be equal to, let me check, this is going to be equal to 233.6 newtons. So this is the value of p, okay, this is the force with which you need to drive this this wedge in the downward direction. So guys, this is exactly how this force p can be calculated with the help of analytical technique. F of x and f of y, all the forces, is equal to 0. Stay tuned, as in the next video I'll explain you how the same problem can be solved with the help of Lamy's theorem. It's going to be fun, very less time consuming, and very intuitive. So stay tuned.